The goal of the Women's Foundation of Arkansas is to help women reach their full potential. And one of the strategies we believe is really helping women economically be the best version of themselves, finding that financial kind of independence. And what better way to do that than to be successful in business? So I'm incredibly proud of the women we have here at this table tonight. They're going to talk to you a little bit about their stories.
We're also very much involved in our community. We're involved in a part of a downtown called SoMa, and there's been so many new businesses open up there in the last 5 years that mostly are owned and operated by women.
For us in marketing, when the economy is doing well, we do well, because the first thing that people cut when things aren't going well is marketing. So, and we've seen great growth over the past 2 years, so it's good. We also do a lot of work. We have a great mix of clients from really large brands to startups, but specifically on the startup front, we have had, even just in the past 6 months, several new clients come on board that are in the startup community, and it's really exciting. Now there's a lot going on here. There's a lot going on in Northwest Arkansas. We're up there a lot, and that's where actually the majority of our startup clients are right now.
So we do free one-on-one consulting engagements. We do about 35 a month, so one plus a day. It's a lot. There's a lot of entrepreneurs coming here, and we see all stages of growth and people who are. Things that they have a full-time job, but they're like, I don't even know where to start. For people who are like, okay, I'm this far, and I'm kind of the wall, we can down with the makers, I take a prototype stuff, which is awesome. We just help someone get a traditional patent. As your very first day, our maker started working there, we helped someone develop a prototype.
You know, all small minority and small businesses face that access to capital challenge. So all of them gonna do that. But we want them to have been in business for 2 years. So there's going to be kind of like that learning curve. Some things are going to be done at that particular time. So I think that it's going to be very helpful, because if they come to us and they have not been in business for 2 years, then we're going to provide them with technical assistance. We're also going to connect them with some of our resource providers, because there is just an array of resources that are out there that can provide services to help these businesses to grow.
Well, I know we have more female venture capitalists, but they can absolutely be doing the exact same thing, and they would be getting more female deals and startups. So, female-run startups. So, I think it's uneven, but I think more women should come to play in that regard.
And there's so much opportunity if these companies can get the capital they need and can get the support they need. We could change the faces and things in the state.
And I didn't know really how to execute it completely, and I didn't know if I was ready, I didn't know if I had the resources, I didn't know if I was up to the challenge. But his message was, whatever you think, be bold and go do it. There's no time to waste.
Men can be mentors just really like a woman could, in just your early stages of your career, just, you know, saying, hey, I want to give you a teachable moment right now, because you're going to, this is going to serve you well later on.
You guys are amazing. It was really important to us to have a range of industries here, so we could hear just how the difference, but yet it's all the same, being in business and being courageous and being bold and taking a step out of our comfort zone and just going for it. Like Shelly said, just go for it. There's no time better than now. But thanks again for coming, everybody.